For most of us, many of the same fundamental questions apply. Who am I? Where am I going? How can I receive the love that I need? For perhaps nobody else do these questions seem more primal, more intense than for the American teenager. High school junior Mandy Abernathy is about to encounter the truth that the best possible answers to her questions may also be the hardest to accept.
Los chicos vayan a clase de español cada día, en un día más diferente que los otros.
Sin dar muestras de querer segundar sus primeros devianos, en los cuales días paso graciosa, cuentos con sus dos compadres, el cura y el barbero, sobre que el de quía, que la cosa de que más necesidad tiene el mundo era de caballeros andantes y de que en él se resucitase la caballería.
That's it!
Chill, Chrissy.
You want me to chill? Why don't you chill, Cole?
Oh my God.
I'm done. We are done.
Permission to go to the bathroom?
Granted. So let's return to our narrative. What did the girl in the Spanish class want? Mandy Abernathy, what do you say? What did the girl in this story want most of all?
Uh,
You won't find the answers you're looking for there, Mandy. I know I'm just a substitute teacher, but we are supposed to be learning Spanish in this room, see?
Si. Señor Camino.
You can retrieve this after second period. I'll still be here. Class dismissed. Gracias, estudiantes. Have a great homecoming weekend.
Go for it, but don't make it seem like you are. Lord, please help me.
Oh, jeez. Sorry.
No, it was my fault. Hola, Cole. ¿Cómo estás?
What? Oh, yeah. I'm just a little embarrassed, I guess.
Yeah, that was mental. She was way over the line. If you need anyone to talk to...
I just need a little space right now, okay?
Oh, of course, sure, sorry. That was an epic disaster.
Too soon?
Way too soon. Oh, if it wasn't hopeless before, it is now.
Don't say that, Dudette. I saw the way he was smiling at you in class.
Then, before I turned myself into a desperate girl right before his face. Totally blown it.
Ow! What is this quitter talk I'm hearing? Are you the captain of the girls' soccer team or what?
This is so different.
No, it's only different in your mind.
Are you doing the Yoda thing again?
True, it is.
It doesn't work on me. This is impossible.
So this is impossible, huh?
Pretty much.
Snagging the cutest boy in school is not possible for Mandy Abernathy?
Yeah. Basically.
Well, then it's a good thing you believe in miracles, don't you?
Yes. Yes, I do. I have an idea. Oh, I need my phone, though. I'll text you when I get it back. I'm gonna need you during the lunch break. Are you in?
Who just gave you the pep talk?
Yeah, girl,
I'm in.
You're the best. Señor Camino?
Hi, Mandy. Come on in. Please leave the door open. Abuse prevention rules. Sadly, the state of the world you live in today. You have a big request, Mandy. And I've got your answer.
It's not that big. I just want my phone back. Please.
Certainly, but I was thinking of another question you've had about a certain upperclassman.
I don't know what Chrissy told you, but I swear I didn't do anything to make her blow up and act all drama queen like that.
Don't worry, nobody told me anything.
Then I'm not sure what you think you know.
Well, for one thing, I know how you met Cole Bix. He was here and Spanish 3. This class is mostly for juniors, but Cole had to repeat it. Your usual teacher, Mrs. Vargas, she was introducing a new learning exercise.
Today, ladies and gentlemen, hoy, señoras, señoritas, vamos a jugar un juego. We're gonna play a game. Llamado Pirámide. It's called Pyramid. Maybe you've seen it on TV.
Vamos a ver, ¿quién va a jugar? Cole, ven acá, vamos a jugar.
My boy!
¿Y quién más? ¿Y quién más? Mandy, ¿y tú también? Vamos. Vamos a jugar. Por favor. Okay, you know the rules. No hand gestures, please, and no English. No inglés. ¿Comprendes, Cole?
Sí, señora Vargas.
¿Preguntas?
No, señora Vargas.
A ver, vamos.
Cuadrillos? Ladillo. Ladillo? Ladrillo? Mucho ladrillo.
¿Cosas que usan para construcción?
No. Peso.
Peso.
Peso bruto.
Cosas que son pesadas.
Ah, sí, correcto. Muy bien. Bien hecho.
And in that moment, you sensed a vulnerability behind Cole's confident exterior that melted your heart. Ever since that day, you and your friend Roxana have been privately referring to Cole as Uno, as in numero uno, number one, cutest boy around. And since this morning's incident, you two have been scheming up a way to manipulate Cole into inviting you to tomorrow's dance. Those are just the highlights.
How do you, like, know that stuff? Who are you?
Who do you say I am?
I don't know. The only people in the universe that know that stuff are me, Rox, and Señor Camino de la Vida. The way of life.
Your Spanish is really coming along well, Mandy. More commonly, I'm called Jesucristo, or sometimes El Salvador.
No way.
Way.
Okay. Then when was I baptized?
On your 13th birthday.
How many goals did I score last year? Who's my favorite member of Mumford & Sons?
You don't have one.
Get out.
But you invited me here.
I'm sorry, Lord. I did? How? This is so crazy.
You've been making the same request of me every single day for the last several weeks.
Oh, I'm so sorry. I didn't mean to bug you.
No, you're not bugging me, daughter. In fact, I've come to answer your question.
You have?
No.
I'm sorry, it kind of sounded like you said no.
That's correct. I won't help make Cole Bix your boyfriend. My answer's no.
Well, could you make him like me? I can pick it up from there, okay?
Cole has plenty of reasons to like you already.
Then could you help him realize that? Just send his attention my way. Make him forget that desperate girl move today.
No.
That's it? Just no? You don't even seem all that sorry about it.
Mandy, I don't do things that I'm sorry about, not in the way that you mean it.
Well, then you can't be the real Jesus Cristo, dude.
What makes you say that?
I go to Bible study. I pray all the time. And I even used to wear one of those what would Jesus do bracelets. So I know a little something about this, Señor Camino. The real Jesus helps people.
Mandy, we aren't done here.
I am. I have to get to algebra, which you would know if you were the real Jesus. Can I please have my phone back? You promised.
And the real Jesus always keeps his promises.
Whatever. And really, she's not even worth it, man.
Bro, it's totally not. She's
not. Hey, Mandy! ¿Cómo estás?
Bien, gracias.
Cool. I just want to say, I was kind of rude earlier, so I...
I was invading your space.
I'm sorry.
You're so shameless, Cole Bix.
What?
You said you didn't even know her, you cheater.
I don't. I just ran in.
I just ran in.
Chrissy, why do you even care? You're the one who said we're over.
Couldn't even wait a day?
I just ran into her.
Yeah,
like...
I just... I'll see you later, Cole. Hey, Rox.
Hey. Drama much?
Did you see her? Acting all totalitarian?
I know. After she dumped him in public like that, news alert, Chrissy, it's a free country, and Cole is a free man.
Even that substitute wants me to stay away from Cole. What's with that?
The sub? Mr. Camino? He told you to stay away from Cole?
Well, not in so many words, but that was the gist. The guy's nuts. You wouldn't believe me if I told you what he said to me.
What about that idea you had?
Right. I'm gonna need you by the gym during lunch. Are you still in?
Always.
Thank you. Okay. I will text you the deets.
Okay, got it.
Okay.
Him make the first move.
Hey, Mandy.
Oh. Hey, Cole.
Hey, I was just sneaking home for lunch. You won't tell anybody.
Everyone needs some time to get away.
Yeah, for me, it's like every day.
Maybe you're more of, like, an introvert than people realize?
Probably. You have a ball. What position do you play?
Halfback. What about you?
Power forward.
I knew that. I was kidding. You're the top scorer for power forward on the West Coast for high school.
Hey, Hey, kiddo, pass me that ball.
No handsies.
Yeah, yeah.
So you've got some skills.
Yeah, I used to play AYSO soccer as a kid. Loved it. Probably more than b-ball. Actually, a lot more than b-ball.
So then, why aren't you on the soccer team?
My dad. He told me the scholarships are better for basketball. With my height, the potential on the court is higher than on the field.
Well, what would make you happier?
I don't know. You know, I don't really think anybody's ever asked me that before.
Not just anybody, I hope.
I don't know. Kids I hang out with, the guys on the team and the cheerleaders, everybody thinks they know me. They all want me to act a certain way, be the basketball hero, but...
They don't realize your hidden depths and stuff?
Yeah, hidden, anyway. You know, you're really cool to talk to.
Thanks. You too.
Maybe, I don't know. Who's taking you to homecoming?
Nobody.
Nobody?
I was asked, but I don't know. I got tired of going with my second or third pick, you know? I've always gone to the dances with the boy my parents thought I should, you know?
Yeah.
Why do you ask? Mandy? Mandy? Bogey's incoming. Close the deal. Mandy? Mandy?
Well, I was just thinking that.
Hey, Cole! Bro! Hey, get in! We're gonna go to the liquor store to get a keg for the after party tomorrow!
A keg?
Yeah, it's just... It's a guy thing. Maybe later, bro.
Dude! Come on! We need your ID!
Okay, okay. Give me a second. Hey, you wanna meet after school here? Maybe I could get those digits. Your phone number. After school?
Okay.
Hey, you're the best. Thanks.
All right. What's your deal?
Could you be more specific?
Are you sabotaging me and Cole?
Cole Bix joining his friends to purchase a keg of beer that they're not old enough to drink. Do you think that's a part of my plan?
Well, why didn't you do something about it? It's not fair.
I think we've been through this already. Besides, you decided that I'm not the real Jesus, so how can I do anything?
Well, maybe I was wrong. Maybe it is you. And close the door, people will hear me.
As I explained, the door has to stay open. If you don't want people to hear you, I suggest you lower your voice.
Okay.
Mandy. You must know that I am the Good Shepherd. And that I know my flock. Cole Bix is not one of my flock, sadly.
But Mandy, you are. Why would you want to date a boy who's off following his own path?
Because I think he's, like, really close to believing. Don't you? Well, I could, like, minister to him and help him accept you. He's a really nice boy deep down.
Mandy, I did not come to call nice people. Does a healthy man need a doctor? You know the answer to that question. I came to call sinners to turn and be healed.
But I could totally help with that. I'm sure I can evangelize him. I've got the sinner's prayer memorized.
Do you know the depths of Cole's sins and struggles?
No, but I know I can bring him to the light. I'm sure of it.
Mandy, why do you believe you need Cole Beck so badly? What is it that's missing in your heart?
Well, you know, so I'm good at sports and stuff. Everyone's always treated me like I'm a boy. But with Cole, it's so different. I just want to be a girl with a boy who loves her. A boy that she actually wants. Is that too much to ask?
No, it's not.
Then why won't you answer my prayer?
I have answered your prayer.
I know. My youth pastor always tells me, God always answers sometimes yes, sometimes no, sometimes wait.
I like that, young man.
But why do I always get answer number two, and girls like Chrissy Carillion always get answer number one?
Mandy, if you only knew, you wouldn't switch places with Chrissy for the whole world.
If you say so.
Mandy? You've studied my book. Remember the words of Isaiah, "For my thoughts are not your thoughts, neither are your ways my ways, declares the Lord."
As the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts than your thoughts.
Mandy, if you know that truth, why don't you shape your request to fit it?
What do you mean, like how?
Well, something like, Lord, would you want me to date Cole Biggs? Is he the best you have for me?
But how could he not be? When I'm with Cole, it feels so right.
Mandy, who do you call Lord? Me or your feelings?
So I should stop praying then?
No, I would never tell anyone to do that.
But you also told people to ask and they would receive.
Yeah. Mandy, if you asked your parents for a scorpion, would they give it to you?
Of course not. I wouldn't be dumb enough to ask for one.
What if you didn't realize it was a scorpion? Should they still give it to you? Mandy, my no is kinder than any yes that the world can offer you. Whether you accept it or not, that's your choice, but so are the consequences. Mandy, continue to pray. But seek first to do my will. Gotta keep your eyes on the ball.
Dear Lord, this is the last time I'm gonna ask.
If it's your will, please let Cole ask me out.
Hey.
Hey!
Thanks for showing up. Can I get those digits? You don't know your own phone number?
626-555-4343. I never call myself.
Right. Cool. I'll call you ASAP. See ya.
No, wait. Cole? I don't think so.
Sorry, what?
Homecoming's tomorrow night. A girl shouldn't be left hanging. If you want to ask me out, now's the time.
All right. Miss Mandy, would you care to join me for a homecoming dance tomorrow evening?
I would be delighted.
Cool. I'll see you at 6.
Text me and I'll send you my address.
I'll see you around.
Not if I see you first. Yes! Oh, thank you, Jesus. Oh, I knew you wouldn't let me down.
What are you talking about?
A flower.
Hey, I brought you here, all right?
Are you okay?
Do I look okay?
You look great, but you're acting really weird. Have you been drinking?
Ha! What makes you say that?
Well, you're driving for one.
You've never ridden with me before.
You smell like a bottle of cologne.
Are you gonna be like this all night?
What are you talking about? Why are you acting like this?
Stop.
This is not.
Stop. You know, just checking out the scene.
My boy!
Hello, hotness. 12 o'clock.
Chrissy's here.
Yeah?
She's
yeah?
looking for you.
Tell her to get in line.
Are you okay?
No, I'm not okay.
Then go get something to drink.
Which reminds me.
Oh, I gotta go make a pit stop.
Hey, homecoming queen. Is everything all right? They should have taken each other to the homecoming.
For real? This is turning out to be a nightmare. You guys just got here. You're lucky you were in here on the drive over. I thought we were gonna die like twice.
Lousy driver, huh?
Earth to Roxanna. He's been drinking.
Are you sure?
Way sure. Listen, girlfriend, you need to relax. This is your night. This isn't how I wanted it to be.
You are at homecoming with the most popular boy in school, Mandy. How can it get any better than this?
He's not paying any attention to me.
Well, are you paying any attention to him? Don't blow all of our hard work.
What am I supposed to do?
Leave. Now, before things get worse.
Hey, where's the flask at?
Dude, I don't know, man. You're the one who brought it.
So you're the one who drunk all of it.
What? Wait, you set this whole thing up, remember? You changed your mind.
No, I never changed my mind.
You said yes.
My answer has always been no.
Then how did all of this happen?
You disobeyed me and made it happen.
Well, if you were the real God, then why didn't you save me?
I am saving you from it. Do you see that? In a few moments, things are going to get worse. The police will be called. Students will be suspended. Do you want to be a part of that, Mandy?
Hey, look at Mandy Abernathy all blinged out.
Excuse me?
Cole has seriously lowered his standards, don't you think?
Wait a sec. You broke up with him.
And after he gets what he wants from you, who do you think he's going to come running back to?
Hey, enough. Chrissy, go. Now.
That's not my problem.
It is when Coach is gonna find
it,
Cole.
Don't touch me.
Do it one more time, see what's gonna happen.
Don't touch me, man.
This isn't funny, Cole.
Stop touching me. All right.
Oh, stop touching me.
Chill out, dude.
What are you
gonna do? Chill out,
Mandy.
Chill out.
Mandy, Chrissy.
Oh, yeah?
Huh?
This is your last chance, man.
How do I get home?
Call your parents.
My parents?
Come on, guys. Work it up.
Let's do what happened.
Yeah?
Do what
things are so big, man.
Yeah, Cole.
All come on, buddy.
Come on, buddy.
Yeah, you're gonna die.
You really messed up, didn't I?
Those who have ears should listen.
This is so unfair. I had nothing to do with that fight, and now I have to stay after school for 2 hours every day until the end of the semester.
Sorry, Rox.
How did you manage to escape?
It's a long story.
Well, aren't you the lucky one?
Oh, believe me, luck had nothing to do with it.
Well, enjoy your freedom.
See you at practice?
Sure, as soon as they unchain me.
I hope so. Team's not the same without you. Hope you know that.
Here comes Uno.
Hey.
Hi.
I just wanted to say how sorry I am about the dance. The way I acted was very uncool.
Apology accepted.
Thanks. And Chrissy and I are over. For real. Her parents grounded her on top of the detention.
I'm sorry to hear that.
So, I was thinking, maybe I could make it up to you this Saturday? You and me and maybe a movie?
Would you answer a question first?
Sure.
This might sound weird. How do you feel about Christ?
What, like Jesus Christ?
Right.
Honestly, he's not really on my radar. I mean, like, I know who he is and all, but religious stuff, that's not really for me. I mean, I'm cool with it if that's what you're into.
Well, if that changes at all, let me know. But until then, this
might not make sense to you, and it might sound a little mean, but it's really the most kind answer I can give you. No. Thank you for asking, though.
Have our questions. Today, Mandy Abernathy has encountered the truth that the hardest answer to accept can also be the best one.